Hello friends, this is Pooja and you're watching cookwithpooja.com. Today we are going to prepare very delicious yet very healthy recipe that is red kidney beans gravy and popularly known as rajma masala. It's one of my very favorite recipes, red kidney beans cooked in Indian spices with onion tomato based gravy. So let's have a look at the ingredients first.
We need 1 cup of red kidney beans, 1/2 a teaspoon of turmeric powder, 1 teaspoon of red chili powder, 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, that's jeera, 1 1.5 teaspoons of salt, 1 teaspoon of garam masala and 2 teaspoons of coriander powder, 2 onions thinly chopped, 2 tomatoes thinly chopped, fresh chilies and fresh coriander thinly chopped, garlic 2 to 3 cloves chopped, and 1 to 1.5 inch of ginger pieces, 1/2 of it thinly chopped and 1/2 of it thinly sliced into small pieces or grated, and 2 bay leaves and about 2 tablespoons of oil. That's it with the ingredients. Let's start preparing it.
When preparing rajma or red kidney beans, we need to do some pre-preparations. That is, we need to soak the rajma or red kidney beans overnight for or at least for 7 to 8 hours before we start preparing them or boiling them. That will be the first step to prepare rajma. But what if I want to prepare rajma right now and I have not done no pre-preparations? That also can be done. Today I'm going to show you a way of making rajma right away without any pre-preparations. Now I have just washed and soaked my rajmas for just 10 minutes. I'm going to put them into a pressure cooker. And double the quantity of water. I have added 1 cup of rajma, so 2 cups of water. Add 1 teaspoon of salt, some grated ginger or very thinly sliced ginger pieces or julienne. Just give it a mix and close the lid of the pressure cooker, and we are going to pressure cook it for about 3 whistles. This should take about 5 to 7 minutes. After 3 whistles, I've just closed the flame. We will let the pressure release and then we will open the lid after that and see.
After releasing the complete pressure, we will open the lid of the cooker and check on the rajmas. See, they are semi-boiled by now. Now to these semi-boiled or partially boiled red kidney beans or rajma, I'm going to add 1 cup of cold water. Mind it should be cold water. This will actually help the rajma to cook very faster. Next, I'm going to add just a teaspoon of oil. That's it. Give it a mix. And again, we are going to pressure cook them for next 3 more whistles or about 8 to 10 minutes.
You might have noticed that I added cold water. Adding cold water actually helps rajma to cook faster and also inside out. Also, I added drops of oil. That's a good practice. Secondly, I added ginger pieces. That is good for digestion, and also the rajma will soak the flavors of ginger while boiling. After 3 whistles, I've just closed the flame now. Now we will wait for the pressure of the cooker to release and then we will check on our rajmas.
Release the complete pressure and we will open the lid and see whether our rajma are completely cooked or not. Let me check whether the rajma are completely cooked. Yes, they are. I can make it by having a look only. Let me just see. Yes, it's completely cooked and properly cooked without even soaking them. So we are done with boiling of our rajma.
Now let's prepare the gravy for rajma. Heat a pan or a wok. Add 2 tablespoons of oil.
Add 2 bay leaves, chopped garlic and ginger. Once they begin to slather a bit, I'm going to add a teaspoon of cumin seeds. Once the garlic is golden brown in color, I'm going to add chopped onion. I'll add half a teaspoon of red chili powder to the onions. Give it a nice mix, as this will give nice color to the onions. Now we are going to cook the onions for about 2 to 3 minutes until they are golden brown in color. After cooking for 2 to 3 minutes, our onions are golden brown in color now.
Now I am going to add the tomatoes and cook them until they are soft. Also, I want to give a tip here. If you are using ginger garlic paste instead of freshly chopped ginger and garlic, that needs to be put after the frying of onion is completed. And when it is chopped, it should be before onion. So this difference we should always keep in mind when we are using chopped or paste of ginger garlic.
Our tomatoes are soft now. I'm going to add chopped green chilies. Mix them. And very little turmeric powder, about just 1/4 teaspoon. Half a teaspoon of red chili powder. And 2 big teaspoons of coriander powder. And give it a nice mix. Half a teaspoon of salt. And give it a nice mix. Now I'm going to cover it with a lid and cook for 2 to 3 minutes until the oil separates from the gravy. Now let's remove the lid and check. Yes, see, oil has separated from the masala and it looks perfect. Just mash it a little bit with the spatula itself. And now we are going to add the boiled rajma or red kidney beans to the gravy. Now we will add the boiled rajma or red kidney beans and cook with the onion tomato based gravy. Mix the rajma well with the gravy. And we will cook them like this for 1 more minute. Now we will add the cooking liquor or the water left behind while boiling rajma, as this has all the flavors of ginger, rajma in it, so never discard this water. And give it a good mix, and if needed we will add some extra water also for the gravy.
We will bring the rajma to boil on a medium flame. This should take about 3 to 4 minutes, but before that add 1 teaspoon of garam masala and mix well and let the rajmas come to boil.
Now the rajma has come to a boil. Let me just give it a good plaster. Perfect. Wow, you can look at the consistency, the color. Awesome. Just garnish it with fresh coriander and you're ready to serve.
Our rajma masala is ready. Let's just taste it. Wow. Awesome. It's very yummy and delicious. Till then, I go have my rajma rice. You don't forget to try this recipe at home. Also, stay tuned with cookwithpooja.com for more such delicious and easy recipes. And please don't forget to subscribe us at cookwithpooja.com and like us on facebook.com. Bye-bye.